Overseas now, and Vladimir Putin has effectively confirmed the death of former mercenary leader Yevgeny Prigozhin while denying he had anything to do with Prigozhin's plane falling out of the sky in flames. Using the past tense, Putin described him as a talented businessman, but one who made serious mistakes in staging a mutiny in June. US officials say they don't believe the plane was shot down, saying an explosion on board was the more likely cause.
We don't have any information to indicate right now. The press reporting stating that there was some type of surface-to-air missile that took down the plane, that we assess that information to be inaccurate.
Meanwhile, Ukraine has marked its Independence Day 18 months after the war began. President Volodymyr Zelensky led his people in honouring those who have given their lives fighting the Russian invasion. Three people have been shot dead as a retired police officer opened fire inside a biker bar in California. The man had arrived intending to attack his estranged wife, who was among the six people injured.
Mr. Snowling, the suspect, then started randomly shooting at patrons within Cook's Corner. That progressed to the outside area.
There he engaged in a shootout with officers before he was himself eventually shot dead. Peru is the latest country to face deadly wildfires, with at least five people killed in the foothills of the Andes. 10 others have been injured as the blaze burns into a fourth day. All the victims are believed to have been fighting to contain the fire, with authorities investigating how it started. The consequences continue for the head of Spanish football over that unwanted kiss after Spain's World Cup win. FIFA is now investigating LuisRubiales' behaviour towards Jenni Hermoso during the medal presentation. Rubiales was also seen grabbing his crotch while celebrating alongside the Spanish Queen and her daughter. Reports out of Spain say Rubiales has conceded defeat and intends to resign in the coming days. It is weigh-in time at London Zoo. Zookeepers have been tasked with getting the measurements of more than 19,000 animals. Some are a little easier to check than others, with more creative means being required for things like tigers and gorillas. All the data helps assess the overall health of the animals, and for some species is the surest way of telling if they are pregnant.